Okay, with Java switch, this is used to select many code blocks to be executed, and this is the syntax. So as you see, expression here is like a variable, and then the value of that variable are the different cases. Now you also have the statement break as well as default, which will be discussed below. How it works. First, you use switch expression or the keyword switch to evaluate an expression. And then the value of the expression is compared with the value of its cases. So yun yun. May variable dito like level. And then yung mga value on its cases could be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Ganyan yung mga case. If there is a match, the associated block of code is then executed. Yun, dito, yung nasa after ng colon. Yan yung block of code that gets executed in cases of a match. And the statement break and default or these keywords are optional and will be described later. So for now, we have an example here. This is for day, wherein it refers to weekday, na Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So initially, you have the value which is 4. Let's try this one para nakikita natin yung implementation, actual implementation with Java. So yung day 4, day is equal to 4. Yung 1 there is Monday, yung 2 is Tuesday, 3 Wednesday, and last day. Your case 4 is Thursday. For break statement, notice that individual cases had break statement after the statement to be executed. And the purpose of that is for switch to end. Yun yung ending niya. Yun yung terminator. Oh, in real world, you would imagine for a water pipe wherein nagpo-flow dyan yung tubig. So parang yung break statement is whenever na yung flow is papunta doon sa case na yon, magsa-stop na siya. Meron siyang stopper. Ibig sabihin, it won't go through the statements in case 2, 3, 4, or the rest of the statements. In this sample, where day is equal to 4, okay, ayan yung variable day natin. Case 1, hindi. Case 2, hindi rin. Dito siya sa case 4, it gets a match and therefore it would print Thursday, which is actually naka-display ngayon sa screen. And therefore, encountering the break statement, it will simply get out of the switch block, which is dito. Okay? Copy? Ganun lang siya, students. So, halimbawa, yung day natin dito is 7. Ganyan, 7. So, dadaanan niya ngayon lahat ito in order to get a match. And dito siya makakakita ng match na yan. And therefore, it will display Sunday. Ayan o. Let's try run this code ulit. Yan. Klaro? So ulit ha, na-describe ko na yung purpose ng break is for individual case match, mag-end na siya or it goes outside of the case block. Now, wala dito yung default, students. Yung default is, yan, nadagdag ko dito yung default. Ayan. This is naman for value of an expression that does not get a match. So, about my spelling is wrong. Pag walang match, dito siya mag-fall. Para siyang, ano, mag-fall, get the term. Para siyang catcher. So, system.out.println. say invalid. There's no such invalid day na lang. Ayan. So, halimbawa, valid day, try again. Something like that. Halimbawa, okay. Let's have 12. So, diba? 7 lang naman yung day. So, ano yung i-expect mo? You'll place that within default. And the, ano, the good news, students, is with default, you don't need a break statement after the statement. Kasi nga, ito na yung last. Nasa pinakailalim na siya. Nasa pinakabottom na. So, ganun yun. Valid day or no such day, something like that. Try again. So, mas better siguro yun. Oh, diba? Grabe. Pa 1,000 yun alagre. Yore, imo nga panampuayan. Copy? Copy, students. Yun yung purpose ng default statement. It only gets here whenever walang case matching prior to the default statement. Okay. Ito na yung trick. Babalik ko sa 4. Hindi kayo nagtatanong, pero papaliwanag ko na agad sa inyo. Advance tayo ha. Halimbawa, hindi mo nalagyan ng break. Eliserio, pagtapos nalagyan ng break ha. Pag nag-terminate, nalagyan ng break. Yung case 4, yan. Case 4 tsaka case 5, hindi natin nilagyan ng break statement. Okay, sama na rin natin itong 7. Okay, and let's see what happens. Jesus. Okay. Ano sa palagay nyo ang nangyari, students? For day 4, okay, it does not match case 1, case 2, and case 3. Okay, dito siya nag-match sa case 4. It happens na, di ba, naalala nyo yung aking nire-relate kanina na water pipe? So, syempre, kung waimaw it pang close ng faucet, it would flow pa, di ba? It would flow down to case 5. Wala ring break doon sa case 5. So, nagkaroon na siya ng dalawang cases. Parang relasyon lang. Nagkaroon na dalawang relasyon kasi walang break. Tama? You understand, students? Then, case 6, hindi idinama yung case 6 dahil may break statement naman. Okay. Case 7, nadamay uli, student. Ayan. So, lahat ng mga cases walang break. Damay-damay na lahat. Gets? So, for individual cases, maglalagay ng break. Yung hindi lang kailangan ng break statement is yung default statement. Klaro? Java reaches a break keyword, meaning it breaks out of the switch block. This will stop the execution of more code and case testing inside the block. When a match is found and the job is done, it's time for a break. There's no need for more testing. So kung may match na nga, di ba? No need na yung the rest na nasa ilalim. A break can save a lot of execution time because this will simply ignore the execution of the rest of the code in the switch block. The default keyword, may gulay. Na-integrate ko na kanina. Hindi ko alam meron para dito. Surprise! The default keyword specifies some code to run if there is no case match. May tendency kasi, di ba? For gender, for instance, M tsaka F. Pero pwede magpinaumang sanda, let's say, naglagay ng ibang letter. So, ano sasabihin mo doon, di ba? Like the experience ideal kanina na nalalagay tayong no such thing as that day, mga ganyan. Or walang nagmatch. Oh, yun yung purpose ng default. Instead na sabihin mong mali yung sagot mo, ay be friendly, be kind. try again, ganyan. Ano pa? Sa year level, for instance, di ba? Freshman, junior, sophomore, and senior. Ay, si lokong estudyante, si Dicoloco, ay, Diocolano pala, nilagay ng year level is 7. O, ano ngayon sasagot ng iyong sweet statement sa 7? Na pwede mong sabihan na invalid, and that's the purpose of the default keyword. Okay, students? Looking forward for the weekend. Note that if the default statement is used as the last statement in the switch block, it does not need a break. Wala na siyang break statement. Okay, we have the exercise. Start the exercise. Who wants to answer the first one? Meron tayong dalawang exercises. Okay. Sausa. Sige, Sausa. Na-miss ko si Sausa eh. Maraming absent.
Day, which day?
Yeah. Tama.
Case.
Yes.
Case ulit. Tapos saka yes. Break na ulit.
Okay. Okay. Next tayo. Lower mo na. Lower your hand. Virtual hand. Exercise 2. Complete the switch statement and add the correct keyword at the end to specify some code if there, ano ra? If there is no case match in the switch statement. Senyora. Senyorito.
Switch day, case 1, case 2, break, default ma'am.
Yeah, tama. Tama lahat. Okay, wala na. Tapos na. End na. Ah! Loops. Okay. So we're done with switch cases. Let's continue with loops. May tanong so far. Ah, the reason pala why I started this one kanina. Na-configure ko ba ito ng tama? Ah, hindi. Hindi ko ito na-configure. This one. Okay. Gawa tayo ng sample problems. Sa switch tsaka sa if. Okay, exercises pala ito, students. Exercises. Machine exercises. Okay, number one. Create a program that would input a numeric year. ASUS, a numeric year. Numeric input a number lang. Input a number. Then determine if it is odd or even. Okay, pwede niyong gamitan ng if or else. If or, okay, switch pala. If or switch. Pwede na kayo magsimula, students. Program that input year. An integer year. Tama? Then determine
if it is a leap year or not. Number
nakikita niyo naman sa screen ko, di ba? Yan lang muna yung tatlo. Pwedeng, ano? Pwedeng dalawa. If, tsaka switch. Para may options. Pwede pala yun. Tapos, send ko sa inyo via, how do I send that with my students? Dito. Dito yata. I'll get a copy. Hindi ako pwedeng mag-accept pag naka, ano ako? Pag naka-share screen. Ayan, laka mo. Machine exercise. Siron, pag naka-share screen, wala, walang mangyayari sa life natin. Ayan, I sent you the machine exercises na mga problems. Okay, let's try the first one. This is in between. Between, ano ba ito? Odd or even? How do you know that a number is an odd? So let's create a class for that. CC. Let's name this as, alin? Ano na lang, odd even na lang. That job. Sino yung may sagot na? Are you doing your exercise? Pwedeng isulat, pwedeng diretso sa IDE, pwedeng sa phone, bahala kayo kung saan nilalagay yung solusyon. Basta yung proper intentions, yung ating program description like your name, the case study or problem, ilalagay dyan yung date. Hindi yan ako ka-share screen dali yang. Si Iris Gali. Class representative, ano na yung pangalan ulit ng class representative? Huh? Ikaw mag-host. Para ikaw yung mag-admit habang ako ay naka-share screen. Okay, this is about odd or even. I'll make a copy of this. Ayan, dito siya ilalagay banda ha? Sa ilalim ng file name. And then, you could also remove this part. And this one. Okay. First is we import. Odd or even.
Done po, ma'am.
Tapos ka, Juan?
Yes, ma'am.
Abe, ikaw mag-share screen?
Pindon. Tama, sa pindon yan, ah.
Bale ito, ma'am.
Share screen ka?
Dumakbasok, ma'am, sa laptop.
Ay, hindi kita makita kasi na kay Charles yung ano. I-pin mo siya, Charles, para ma-view lahat. Wala, na-close ko yung file ko. Ah, okay.
I-run ko pa ba?
Oo. Ano, may shortcut sa baba ng help? Okay. Hindi ka naglagay ng description. So, when you execute, you would only find a cursor. Ayan, mag-execute ka ulit. Description, syempre. Ayan o, di ba cursor lang yung nag-a-appear? Ano gagawin ko sa cursor na yan? At least, you place a description in print statement that your user would enter an integer value. Di ba? Agree, class? Baliktad yung mundo mo. Nauna yung cursor bago yung description. Description muna. Alright. Bago yung input.
Yung scanner input, ma'am?
No, yung input next in.
Ito, ma'am?
Oo.
Ayun, mag-build ba?
I-ano mo muna? I-stop? Yung may parang flash, ano ron? Energizer? Parang may ano?
Ah, ito ma'am?
No. Oo, stop tool pa yan. Yan. Tapos, build ulit. Walang close. Bago if. Sa ilalim niyan, ayan.
Ayan, dapat print lang pala, walang line. So 69 is an add. The number is add. Okay. Ulit. Run ulit. Let's try an even naman. Okay. Zero. Try zero. Wala kang condition for... Add-even lang pala. Oh, okay, add-even. Yung zero kasi, mag-error siya. Okay na yan. So, the rest of the exercises, gawin nyo na lang ha. Tapos, isubmit doon kasama ng assignment. Yung file name ng number 2 tsaka number 3 exercises would be your last name ulit. Last name ulit. Tapos, lagyan yung MP2. MP na letter M tsaka P ha, hindi imperador. Kabangon MP2. Kabangon MP3. Ganun. And the same drive, kaya magsasubmit, the same folder doon sa assignment ilalagay. Ha? Copy. Bye.